So good morning student, again we will continue our three phase inverter topology with 120 degree mode of conduction. So in previous lecture we will see that in 180 degree mode of conduction thyristors are conducting for 180 degree duration in a cycle of 360 degree, but as the name tells, this is the 120 degree mode of conduction. So in this conduction mode, each thyristors conduct for a 120 degree of a cycle. In each group of thyristors, in each group means there are two groups. One is positive group of thyristors, which consist of T1, T3, T5, and second one is the negative group of thyristors, that is T2, T4, and T6. So in each group of thyristors are fired after every 120 degree. So as in previous 180 degree mode of conduction, T1 is conducting at 0 degree, then after T1, T3 fired at 120 degree duration and T5 at 240 degree duration. So in this case, same as T1 is fired at omega t equals to 0 degree, then T3 at omega t equals to 120 degree duration and T5 at 240 degree duration. Means in each group, either it is a positive group or a negative group, thyristors from the positive negative group are fired at a duration of 120 degree, but individual thyristor is conducting for 180 degree duration in 180 degree mode of conduction, and here each thyristor is conducting for a 120 degree mode of conduction. So what happens with 60 degree out of 180 degree? 120 degree is 120 degree is the thyristors are conducting, but remaining 60 degree out of 180 degree, last 60 degree is allotted for the commutation. So this thing we have to remember, that in 120 degree mode of conduction, last 60 degree is allotted for the commutation. Commutation in the sense, no device is conducting in this period. See, this is a T1 which is conducting. This is a timing sequence diagram in which T1 start at 0 degree and it will conducts up to 180 duration in 180 degree mode of conduction, but T1 will be conducting up to a 120 degree duration in this mode of conduction, and this hedged area is 60 degree, which is allotted for the commutation. So no thyristor is conducting in this area from the positive group. So last 60 degree is allotted for the commutation in 120 degree mode of conduction. Now we will study this ramming sequence diagram. See, T1 is conducting, it is fired at 0 degree and it will be conducts up to 120 degree, and after 120 degree 60 degree is allotted for commutation, and after T1 the T4 is conducting from the negative group and it will be conducting up to 120 degree and 60 degree is allotted for the commutation, and again T1 T4 T1 T4. This is a sequence, one from the positive group and one from the negative group. And after T1, in the positive group, T3 is fired. So if T3 is fired, it will be fired after 120 degree from T1. So T1 is conduct up to 120 degree, and after 120 degree, T3 start conducting and it will conduct up to 120 degree and 60 degrees allotted for the commutation. After T3, T5, because it will belongs to same arm, so T5 will be conducting and to form the closed path. So after T3, T5 will be conducting, and again 60 degree allotted for commutation. T3, T5 in this sense, T3, T5 are conducting. Now we will see this third thyristor from the positive group, that is T5, which will conducts after 120 degree from T3. So after 120 degree of conduction of T3, T5 is fired and it will continue up to 120 degree and 60 degree is allotted for the commutation, and after T5, T2 will be conducting. So in this way, this timing sequence diagram is drawn. So one thing we will have to remember in this mode of conduction is that each thyristor is conducting for a duration of 120 degree duration, and last 60 degree is allotted for the commutation, but in individual positive group and negative group, thyristors are fired at an interval of 120 degree. So in this 0 to 60 degree duration, this is the first step. Thyristor T1 and T6 are here because this is a hedged area, no conduction of device is there. So T1 and T6 are there up to 60 degrees. So 6-1 are conducting, and after 60 to 120 degree duration, and T1 will be there, and in this area no thyristors are conducting, it is a T2. So 60 to 120 degree, 1 or 2 are conducting, and after 120 to 180 degree duration, T3 and T2 are there. So it will be 2-3 will be conducting in this same way. Up to 360 degree, one cycle is completed, and it will be repeating after 360 degree to again one cycle of 360 degree duration. So this is a timing sequence diagram. So in this diagram, we will see that in each interval of 60 degree, two thyristors are conducting. But in case of 180 degree mode of conduction, three thyristors are conducting in each step of 60 degree duration. So we'll understand first 0 to 60 degree duration by seeing the conduction of the devices. So come to this calculation part. Step 1, from omega t equals to 0 to 60 degree, thyristor T1 and T6 are conducting. So we will close T1 and T6, which will be there, and this is a three phase load as in case of previous lecture, which will composed of a equal impedance of Z. So this A phase will be connected through T1 to the positive supply, and this T6 will be connected to this B phase will be connected through T6, and it will connected to negative supply. So, and this C phase will not be connected to T2 and or T5 because these are not conducting, so these are remains as a open circuited. So in this case, A and B phase are coming to picture. A phase will be connected through T1 to positive supply, and this B phase will be connected through T6 to negative supply. So we will draw, then we will make A and B there, and for A to N, so this A phase is connected to plus supply and through Z impedance, and it will be neutral point, and it will be BN, and it has the same impedance Z. So this is the circuit diagram, and now we will calculate the impedance drop across the impedances. So what we will do is the total voltage is Vs, and it has an equal impedance, so half of is divided through the A phase and B phase, so it is plus minus Vs by 2 and plus minus Vs by 2. So total is whole is, if you add both, then it is comes to be Vs. So now we will calculate line to neutral voltage, that is phase voltage. So Vn equals to this is Vs by 2 because A is the higher polarity and N is the lower polarity. So it will be plus Vs by 2, and Vbn equals to Vbn because Nb equals to plus Vs by 2. So Bn equals to minus Vs by 2. So Vbn equals to minus Vs by 2. And what is the Vcn? No Vcn will be there. So Vcn equals to 0. Now we will calculate the line voltage by using this phase voltages. So Vab equals to Van minus Vbn. If we put Vn then Vbn and subtract this, then it will be comes to be Vs. And Vbc, how will obtain? Vbn minus Vcn. So it will be, if we subtract minus Vs by 2 from 0, then it will be minus Vs by 2. And in this similar case, Vca will be obtained to be minus Vs by 2. So if we will draw into the waveform, then Vn equals to for up to 60 degree duration. So Vn equals to Vn equals to plus Vs by 2. So it will be drawn from some level Vs by 2 up to 60 degree duration. And Vbn equals to minus Vs by 2, which is drawn from below the x-axis. And Vcn equals to 0. So it will drawn 0 to up to 60 degree duration in this waveform. And how we'll obtain the line voltage? We will subtract Vn minus Vbn for Vab. And for Vbc, Vbn minus Vcn. And for Vca, Vcn minus Vn. So simply subtract these waveforms, or you can use these calculations to draw the line voltage waveform. So Vn, what will you do? This Vs by 2 minus of minus Vs by 2 to obtain Vab. What will you do? Plus Vs by 2 minus of minus Vs by 2. So it will be Vs will be there. So it is half is Vs by 2 here. So full Vs will be there. So it is a some higher amplitude. We will start this waveform of Vab, and it will comes up to a 60 degree duration. Similarly, we will draw Vbc by subtracting Vbn minus Vcn, and for Vca, Vcn minus Vn, we will do like this. And if we go next step, that is step 2, in which thyristors 1 and 2 are conducting. So if the thyristors 1 and 2 are conducting, then what will be the condition? See, this is a three-phase load. Again, we will see that T1 and T2 are conducting for the next 60 degree duration. So in this case, close this T1 switch and this T2 switch. Now B phase have no devices are conducting, either T3 or T6, no devices are conducting. In this case, A phase is connected to through T1 to plus supply, and in case of this C phase, it will be connected to through this T2 to negative of the VS supply. So A and B C phases are coming into picture. One is connected to plus supply and one is connected to negative supply through thyristors T1 and T2 respectively. So we will draw circuit like this. This is the two impedances. This is a VN and this is a VNC. Now, because B is not there, so this again, this VS is divided into VS by 2 and VS by 2. And line to neutral voltage, which is phase voltage, VN equals to plus VS by 2. VBN equals no there, so VBN equals to 0. And VCN equals to minus VS by 2. Why VCN equals to minus VS by 2? Because VNC equal to plus VS by 2. So VCN equals to minus VS by 2. And if we calculate the line to line voltage, we will subtract these phase voltages to obtain the line voltage. So we will draw the waveform of the this second step, which is 60 to 120 degrees. So in 60 to 120 degree duration, VN equals to plus VS by 2, VBN equals to 0. So VN equals to plus VS by 2. So we will continue this VN waveform after 60 degree. It will be VS by 2 up to a 120 degree duration. And this VBN equals to 0. So we will make this minus VS by 2 waveform. It makes to 0 on the x-axis. And this VCN waveform is going from this x-axis to the minus VS by 2 level up to 120 degree duration. And if we subtract this waveforms of phase voltage, we will obtain the line voltage waveforms. And again, we will study this step third up to 120 degree duration to 180 degree duration with devices 2-3 are conducting. We will draw the waveform of this phase and line voltage respectively. So these are the waveforms of square in nature or stepped nature. So voltage source have a nature of these are the square waveforms. And once the VN is drawn, VBN is drawn by simply seeing this waveform, because we will know VN, VBN, VCN are displaced by 120. So once we will draw the VAN from this point to here, what we will do, we will shift this waveform to 120 degree to obtain the VBN. So if VN start from 0 with amplitude VS by 2, we will shift this point to after 120 degree. So it will start, this is 60 degree, this is 120. So it will start from here and it will conduct up to 120 with a VS by 2. And after this, it will 0 because, so it will be 0 and it will start in negative direction. So it will continue like this. So what we will do, if we want to draw VBN, we will shift VN by 120 degree. And for drawing the VCN, we will shift this VBN waveform further 120 degrees. So if it will start from here with VS by 2 amplitude, we will shift 120 degree, that is 60, that is 60. So we will start this waveform from here and it will just continue like this. And this negative part we will draw by symmetricity. So it is 0 minus VS by 2 and again it is 0. So in this way, VCN will be drawn by shifting VBN waveform by 120 degree. And similar in the case of line voltages, once the VAN is drawn, VAB is drawn, then VBC and VCN will be drawn by shifting 120 degree this VAB waveform from here, and this will VCA will be shifting VBC by 120 degree. So if VBC start from 120 degree, so it is a 60, this is a 60, so we will start this waveform of VCN by shifting this waveform of VB and VBC by 120 degree. In this way, we will draw the VAB, VBC and VCA waveforms, or we simply do by applying the steps analysis, and we will draw the parts by parts up to 60, 120, 180 like this. So these are the waveform for the output voltages in case of 120 degree mode of conduction. Now we'll go to the Fourier series analysis. So this is the Fourier series analysis. In this this is the third step, you can understand easily. And similarly, other steps are solved up to 360 degree at the output voltage phase. So if we write phase voltages Fourier series in case of 120 degree mode of conduction, then it will be summation n equals to 135 to infinite. Why 135? Because there are no triplet harmonics are there. So 2 Vs by n pi cos n pi by 6 into sin n omega t plus pi by 6. So it is similar like the 180 degree mode of conduction, but here 2 Vs by n pi. But in case of 180 degree, it is a 4 Vs by n pi cos n pi by 6 will be there also. So it will be there also. And VBN will be drawn by shifting this VN by 120 degree. So subtract 30 minus 120. So it will be minus 90 degree. And this C phase Fourier series, we will further subtract this 120 degree from VBN. So it will be 5 pi by 6. So in this way, Fourier series for the phase voltages can be written like this. And Fourier series for the line voltages, it will be VAB equals to 6k plus minus 1 to infinite 3 Vs divided by n pi sine n omega t plus pi plus 60 degree. Why plus 60? Because line and phase voltages are shifted by 60 degree in case of star connected load. So similarly, after drawing the VAB, VBC and VCA can be written by subtracting 120 from each other. Because VAB, VBC, VCA are shifted by 120 degree in case of star connected load. So RMS value of fundamental phase voltage. How will calculate the RMS value of fundamental phase voltage? So go to the phase voltage Fourier series and put n equals to 1 for fundamental and divide it by root 2 for the RMS calculation. So this is a phase voltage waveform. VN equals to summation n equals to 135. 2 Vs divided by n pi, this is the expression. If you put n equals to 1 and divide by root 2, then we will obtain the RMS value of this fundamental component of phase voltage. Now we will calculate the RMS value of this phase voltage. So how we will obtain the RMS value of this phase voltage? We apply simple calculation. This is the voltage magnitude of the phase voltage. Go through the phase voltage waveform. You can directly write by seeing the square wave operation area under the curve. So VP RMS, so this is a phase voltage waveform of VAN. So the two thyristors are conducting. So up to 0 to 120 degree duration, this will have the amplitude of Vs by 2. So out of 180 degree duration, 120 degree, the duration at which thyristors are conducting. So 120 divided by 180 into amplitude Vs by 2, we will obtain the RMS value of this phase voltage. So we will calculate Vs by 2 into 2 pi by 3, that is a 120 degree out of 180 degree duration, whole raised to power 1 by 2, because we will calculate the RMS value. So it will obtain to be Vs by root 6. Either we calculate directly or we apply the formula 1 upon pi 0 to 2 pi by 3 Vs by 2 is the amplitude, whole square d omega t and whole raised to the power 1 by 2 for RMS calculation. It will again obtain to be Vs by root 6. So this is the RMS value of phase voltage. So in this way, fundamental phase voltage we will calculate, phase voltage RMS we will have calculated. Now RMS value of fundamental line voltage. So if we divide this fundamental phase voltage by root 3, because in a star connected case, simply if we divide VPH equal to VL by root 3, so we'll obtain the line voltage. So this is the calculation of this fundamental phase voltage. VP1 equals to 2 Vs by root 2 pi cos pi by 6, that is a 0.3898 Vs. If we will divide this by root 3, we will obtain the fundamental line voltage RMS value. And for RMS value of line voltage, we will divide the whole phase voltage, not fundamental in this case, whole phase voltage. If you divide this whole phase voltage, which is Vs by root 6 by root 3, or we will say that VPH equal to VL by root 3, VL equal to root 3 times of phase voltage. So this is the phase voltage RMS value, which is Vs by root 6. If we have multiplied this by root 3, we will obtain the RMS value of line voltage. And similarly, in case of fundamental, to obtain the fundamental, we will multiply this phase voltage by root 3. So in this way, once we have know the RMS value of these phase voltages, line voltages can be calculated by multiplying the root 3. Now we will calculate the power output of the inverter. So simply power is equal to 3 VP RMS whole squared by R, or simply I square R, you can write this. So put the Vp RMS value, which is Vs by root 6. So if you put Vs by root 6, then it will be Vs squared divided by 2R. And the RMS value of thyristor current. How will obtain the RMS value of thyristor current? So to calculate the RMS value of the thyristor current, we will divide the phase current by root 2. Because in each phases, the current which will be flowing, it will be comes from the thyristors. So the phase and thyristors are connected in series. So the current which is flowing through the phases, it will be from the thyristor switches also. So if you divide the phase current waveform by root 2, we will obtain the RMS value of thyristor current. So Ip equals to Vp divided by R divided by root 2. Put the Vp RMS and calculate this. It will be Vs by 2 root 3 R. So in this case, all the calculation are done. This is a summary of this in the tabular form. This is a 120 degree mode of conduction. Here the phase voltage. Second one is the line voltage. So total RMS, which is equals to Vs by root 6. But in case of 180 degree mode of conduction, it will be root 2 by 3 into Vs. So in this case, Vs by root 6 will be there. And fundamental RMS phase voltage will be root 3 by 2 into Vs by pi. And to obtain the line voltage, we multiply these phase voltages by root 3 and the arrow direction. And in the previous lecture, we will see that the fundamental RMS can be obtained by multiplying this phase RMS by 3 by pi, because distortion factor is 3 by pi, and it will have the formula G equals to fundamental RMS upon overall RMS. So to obtain the fundamental RMS, we will multiply G by overall RMS. So in 3 phase inverter case, what is the value of G? It will be equal to 3 by pi. So multiply 3 by pi with this total RMS value, we will obtain the fundamental RMS calculation. So in this way, we will have complete our inverter lecture with the 3-phase 180 degree and 120 degree mode of conduction. Now in the next class, we will continue this inverter lecture with some numericals. Thank you.